I'm going to show you how to use V Petkovic, one of the most defensive managers in Pes 2021 mobile. Also, according to YouTube statistics, only a small percentage of people who watch my videos are actually subscribed. If you end up liking this video, consider subscribing. It's free and you can always unsubscribe after. Now, enjoy the video. So as we look right here, we're going to look at the manager. Basically, the manager is a 5-2-3 formation. So what you do is that you sacrifice a midfield position for a defensive position. So now you have 3 center backs, 2 wing backs, and only 2 midfielders, while you have 3 forwards up front. So it's a simple 1-2. As you look here, the offensive tactics as well as the defensive tactics, they're the same thing. So all you're doing is possession ball game, short pass, wide, flexible front line pressure, and wide and aggressive. So let me just explain how you use this formation quick and easy, because what you guys need to understand is that this formation, though it says short passes, it can be used for long balls. And yes, you're looking at it and saying long ball spam. No, it's not only about long ball spam, but I don't condone doing long ball spamming. But if you're going to do it, you might as well have the right facilities to do it. As the law says, it says attacking wide, right? All you have to do is watch your little wingers, because you're using prolific wingers. So all you have to do is watch your little prolific wingers on the bottom of the screen right there, where you see the little, you know, box that shows you where your players are, and just watch them. Pass it there and just cross it in. Remember, long ball in, cross it in, head it in. That's all you have to do. Just do that, repeat and score and win. Because this formation, mark my words, is very good defensively. It is very good defensively. And it can be a challenge going forward if you don't know how to use it. So yes, short passes do work, but if you don't know how to use pass and go, and if you don't know when to use the pass and go, then it will be a huge problem for you. And we don't want it to be a huge problem for you. We want it to be a quick and easy formation, because previous, most of you guys are afraid of iconic moment Rominique, iconic moment Forlan, iconic moment Torres, you know, Romario, Johan Cruyff, yeah, whosoever you're afraid of. Look at it, this formation is built. Not saying that you won't concede, because you can concede with any formation. Even if you had 10 at the back, you could still concede, because it's PES. PES, you know, allows any goal to score. From if you take a long shot with any player with a long shot ability, they will score screamers, and you're like, fam, I've never ever seen them score that in real life. But yeah, back to what I was saying. You have a higher chance of defending against those iconic moment players, or those players that you fear the most, than if you're using 4 at the back. If you're using 4 at the back, there is a little problem. There's a little discrepancy here and there. The reason why I said there's a little problem right there is because with 2 center backs, there's not enough support. So the 1-2 passes are easier to pass them. So you see, if you have 3 center backs around there, it's going to be harder to pass 3 center backs than to pass 2. So it's like giving you more ammunition, or giving you more defense. So it's like having a great wall and you keep building on it for them to, you know, try and jump over it or climb over it or whatever they're going to do to try and get over it. It's as simple as that. So let's just get into the players, right? Quick and easy. So the first thing I need you guys to do, don't bother putting an offensive goalkeeper. There is no need to put in an offensive goalkeeper, because long balls aren't supposed to pass this formation. One, because you guys watch my defending tip. I hope you guys did. You watch my defending tip, so you know how to stop long ball spammers. I'm pretty sure you know how to do that. If you haven't watched it, stop watching this video right now and go watch that defensive tip. You need to go watch the defending tip right now. Secondly, offensive goalkeepers are a stress, fam. Sometimes they come out, and I don't even know how to explain it, but sometimes they come out and they bounce into your defenders, and then, you know, it gives your opponent an easy shot to score. And we don't want that. I don't want that, at least. It has happened too many times to me, and I argue too many times. So you need a defensive goalkeeper. You have a lot of defensive goalkeepers in the game. You have Oblak, you have Petacek, you have Szczesny, you have, I think, well, I don't, you guys can check out who the defensive goalkeepers are. I can't really tell you who exactly off of the top of my head. But these goalkeepers are more inclined to stay on the line and make better saves. Offensive goalkeepers are caught off the line too easily. It's like, especially if using Cassius. Cassius has to be the worst goalkeeper. I'd rather use a silver ball or a bronze ball goalkeeper than using Iker Cassius. I'm sorry. So your defenders now. Let's just look at this defense real quick. I'm going to switch out Ake. I love using Ake, but that's because of my reasons. What I want you guys to do, I want you guys to use 2 destroyers, that is on the right side and the left side. Switch that left side or the right side. And then in the middle, you have the build-up play. The build-up play is there for the long balls. Because at the end of the day, if you're going to the long bars, you need the right tools. So if you have a build-up play player, that player sits deep as well. So it's going to be a little deeper than the destroyer. The destroyer is going to go a little bit up forward to make those crunching last-ditch tackles. But once they make the tackles, Dilip just intercept and send the ball forward. It doesn't even have to be a long ball, but he still helps with the build-up play. Hence, that's why he's a build-up play. So that's why you have two destroyers and a build-up play player. You can use Ake. Ake is an extra front man. It's just that he will be absent from the defense a couple times and he'll be up there striking, just like what Sergio Ramos does. Your wing backs, I don't even have to look at them, because you know everybody knows that we're using Roberto Carlos and Cafu. They can't really defend that well, so don't really use them. See if you can find a balance between a defending wing back and a, you know, attacking or offensive wing back as well. They aren't really that good in my opinion, but crossing wise, yes, they can cross the ball really, really well. They're fast and you know they can do a little thing, so I use them a lot because you know that's their purpose in life, to ensure that I can cross balls properly and stuff. So you just need a wing back that is quick. So you guys can use Trent Robertson, you guys can use even if you want to use Bissaka. The thing is, Bissaka's crosses aren't really successful, so I wouldn't really recommend using Bissaka. But maybe you can switch it up a bit and put one defensive wing back and have an offensive wing back on the other side. You guys decide. Moving on into midfield, I'm going to switch Pjanic into center midfielder. The reason why I said that is because I actually use a central midfielder, but it's because I was testing out Pjanic at the time, because in an orchestrator, I really like using defensive mid players that are orchestrators. Reason being is because, you know, why would I need a defensive midfielder that is an orchestrator when there are so many center forwards or center mid forwards, my, you know, central midfielders. You guys know my thing already. Not our orchestrators like Paul Scholes, Toni Kroos, etc. So why would I need a defensive midfielder that can do that? So he plays really well in the position. I like using him. Orchestrators like to sit deep, and then you have a destroyer beside him. So that's literally six persons. Well, not even six, actually. That's seven persons right there defending. So it kind of puts a little hole between those and your forward. So that's why you kind of need to utilize those long balls, or maybe they need to sit a little bit, you know, sit a little bit deeper. So as it relates to your wingers up front, I use prolific wingers. I like to use Ansu Fati and Tovan. I don't know how you guys pronounce him. The reason why I use Ansu Fati is because, one, he's right footed. So I don't really need him to cross any ball. He can cross it with his left foot. I have a review coming out for him soon, so just stay tuned for that if you want to learn how to use him properly. Yes, he can, but the main point of a prolific winger is to go down the wing, shift out some people and go score. So what you do is go down the wing, cut in and score. So that's all you need him for. So you see, when seeing that his right foot is his stronger foot, he's more inclined to score better goals because he's always on his stronger foot when he cuts in. So it's easier for him. And you guys know that I love using Rashford, so Rashford is obviously up top. I wouldn't recommend you guys using him unless you guys know how to use him. I'm going to make a review on Rashford as well, so stay tuned for that, because I've scored over 100 goals since PES 2021 has started with Rashford, but that's because I know how to use Marcus Rashford. Most of you guys don't. So use your regular poachers like your Fernando Torres or your there are so many poachers in the game, it's not even funny. I can show you guys a lot of them actually. Just, you know, you can use your Morientes, you can use just use as much as you want. You can even use your Michael Owens. If you have any legends, you have so many strikers out there that you can use. You can use your Tommy Abrams, you can use your Cristiano Ronaldo, even though he's not a poacher, but he still acts as a poacher in center forward position. So that is basically what you guys need to do. As I said, this is a very slow build up formation. It's a very patient one, so you have to learn how to, you know, usually just pass around a bit until a space opens up. It's not a counter attacking formation, so it's not a formation that quick, no. So your players might actually last the entire match without actually needing to actually make a sub. So that's a bonus right there. But at the end of the day, if you're not a patient player, don't use this formation. You can always use Jay Canto, you can always use El Roman, you can always use Zietler or Klopp, you know, you can always use any of those other formations. You can use P Boar if you need, but don't use this formation if you're not patient. If you're patient, use this formation and do wonders with it. I know a lot of people who use this formation and I haven't seen them lose a game or no. I'm not going to tell you that I haven't lost any games. I've lost a good amount of games, but it wasn't because of the formation. It was because of me missing the chances that I should have scored. I'm sure we've all been there before. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to drop a like down below. Sharc Gaming, and I'm out.